is power, power. Here in this hour, this hour, we're all together, together, waiting here as one. From heaven, oh, a mighty rushing wind, oh, we're calling for revival. God, let your fire fall again. It's burning in my soul.
You are listening to Radio Maria Canada, a Catholic voice wherever you are. We now present Give Me a Voice.
Okay, and welcome to another edition of Give Me a Voice, the Catholic radio show for teenagers and young adults here on Radio Maria Canada. My name is Chris Elliott. I am the youth minister from St. Timothy's Church in North York, and I'm here tonight with a young woman who recently attended World Youth Day, and she's graciously agreed to come in and tell us a little bit about that experience because I didn't get to go. So, and I imagine a number of you out there also did not get to go. For those of you that did, lucky you. For those of you that did not, you know, maybe our guest here can share some of her experience and kind of tell us what it was like, what it felt like to be there. So I'm going to let her introduce herself right now.
Well, hi, I'm Natalie Urbank. And yes, I just came back from World Youth Day, which was an amazing experience. I'm currently a teacher, and I hope that you get to learn something about World Youth Day, and I hope that one day you get the chance to come out to World Youth Day and have the same experience that I had, which was really wonderful.
Okay, great. All right, so before we really get into our discussion, I want to begin with some prayer. I always like to bring the Holy Spirit in, and as you know, as we discuss these things. So why don't we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Holy Spirit, you inspire us with the words that we say, and the thoughts in our hearts, and the actions in our lives. And so we ask you to be present with us now in this moment. Help us to hear your voice speaking to us, to understand the messages that you are sending to us, and to put them into action in our lives and whatever you may call us to do. We ask this in the name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so yeah, I'm a little jealous actually that you got to go and I didn't. But I'm hopeful that for the next one, I understand the next one is in 2022, mm-hmm. In Portugal.
Yes.
That I'm planning on taking my youth group to that one. So.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah. Just the idea of that trip was a little intimidating. It's not like going down to, it's not like going down to golf or something like that, you know, when I take the youth group for indoor mini golf. So there's a lot more to it. So first of all, how did you go with a group, or how did you get involved with going to World Youth Day?
So that's a good question. I originally didn't know anybody that was going to this World Youth Day because it was in January, which is a kind of an awkward time for us here in Toronto. In Canada. So I knew I really wanted to go before to the Poland one. However, with the timing, it didn't work out because I was in school. And so I really had that desire to go. And so when I heard that it was in Panama, I really felt like called to go to Panama. because I also have family that lives in Panama, which was like an even a bonus to that, that I had never met before. So I was like, I feel like I'm being called to go to World Youth Day this year for sure. So I think that was 1 year ago. And so I kind of just asked around, where can I find a group that is going to World Youth Day? And it was actually hard to find. But eventually I asked one of my friends, and she told me about the Salesians and that they were all going to go to World Youth Day. So I was really excited, and I emailed the sister in charge, and she told me that they'd be going.
Which sister was that by chance?
Sister April.
Oh, she went too?
Yes.
Oh, she got to go too. I know Sister April.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. She's been on the show before. Oh. Yeah. So from St. Paschal's, right?
Yes.
Yeah. When you said Salesians, I put two and two together, and I thought, oh, she got to go too. And now I definitely have to go next year.
Yeah.
All right. So that's great. So actually going there, it's a big trip.
You know,
so like with a lot of preparations involved. So what sort of things did you have to do to get ready to go?
Well, there were a lot of things to think about before going to World Youth Day. What was amazing was the leader of our group, Marielle from St. Benedict's, she was really organized and helping us get ready. So she had a whole calendar for us to look at in terms of even just physical preparation, mental preparation, and spiritual preparation. So, for example, she had certain saints that were related to World Youth Day. For example, St. John Bosco or St. Juan Diego mm-hmm. and Blessed Maria Romero, kind of all these different days to learn about the different saints, certain days to make certain prayer intentions about World Youth Day, and all these different things. And it was really helpful to have that in terms of having that calendar to kind of think about, this is time to prepare for World Youth Day. And so just having that guidance and meeting with my group about once a month to do fundraisers and to get to know each other, this is kind of how we got ready. We prayed together, we prayed for each other, and then in that way, you know, we're getting ready. Now, when it comes to, you know, the week before the World Youth Day, then it gets real. You know, before that, it just seems like, oh, yeah, we're going to World Youth Day, but it's still far away. Mm-hmm. But once that last week came, it was like, you know, reality check, because we were like, oh, no, we actually, you know, we're leaving next week. Now, when I went to Panama, I actually was first going on my own to meet family. And then I was going to meet up with my group a few days later. And so getting ready was a little bit, I had a little bit of anxiety getting ready to make sure that I have everything I need. So, you know, when we had our meeting 1 week before World Youth Day, you know, they had suggested all these extra things that we should bring to make sure, like, if you get sick, bring these pills, or if, you know, all these different things to have. And every time I talked to someone, they would say, oh, make sure to bring this other thing, and just in case, you know, you never know what could happen. And so every time I'd be like, oh no, another thing that I need to add to my long list. And so every time I would have, like, you know, a longer and longer list. And so it was, you know, I was a little bit scared.
And I imagine you couldn't bring this huge luggage either. So you had to be very choosy about what you brought and how much.
Yeah. I mean, the more that you bring on these kind of trips, it's kind of like, essentially, you have to carry this around in a lot of places. So you kind of don't want to bring too much. But we were pretty lucky. We actually could bring two suitcases. So we were kind of lucky. But keeping in mind that it is a pilgrimage, we were recommended to try to bring as least as possible. And then, you know, but it's kind of ironic because they kept telling us more to bring. But then, you know, yeah, we knew that we're trying to limit it as well.
Now, where did you stay when you got there? Was it a hotel or was it more rustic? Or
So again, we were pretty fortunate in the sense that our group stayed in a hotel.
Okay.
In a very nice hotel. So we got very lucky. However, for me, for the first few days, I stayed with my family. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's lucky.
So yeah. Has,
yeah. So they live right there.
Oh, yeah. Okay. My family lives in Panama. So for the first few days of when I first landed, so on the plane to Panama, I was by myself. Okay. So I was flying out by myself. And then I was going to meet family there on that first day.
Mm-hmm. And so you were telling me off the air, you were saying, now when you got there, you actually started to get, you ended up in hospital before anything even started.
Yes. So the first few, the first 2 days were okay and were wonderful. I got to know my family. I even got to see the Panama Canal, which was absolutely amazing. And I enjoyed my time a lot. However, after those first 2 days, I got extremely ill. I've never been so sick in years. Okay. So I had a fever and I was throwing up a lot and I couldn't even drink anymore, eat everything, I would just keep throwing it up. So
what a beautiful way to start such a spiritual adventure.
I was thinking to myself, okay, this pilgrimage started really, really early. That's what I was thinking in that moment. I was like, oh no. And so, the thing that was wonderful, though, I think that experience was actually kind of something that framed my whole World Youth Day experience, though, because the theme of World Youth Day was around Luke 1, verse 38, mm-hmm. when Mary said yes. Okay, so Mary said, "Let it be done according to your word." And so the idea is that you have to follow God's will. She was willing to say yes to it, even though it may not have been what she wanted, or maybe she was scared of what was going to happen. She didn't know what was going to happen, but she still took the risk to say yes in that moment. And so for me, this was kind of the framing of my experience, because once I got really, really ill, I knew that this was something I really did not want to start my World Youth Day experience, to be very, very sick and very weak, very vulnerable, and starting this huge pilgrimage that is very full of energy. Okay. Honestly, it was really, really hard for me to accept. And so I felt at one point, I think it was on the Tuesday. This was the first day of World Youth Day. So on the Sunday is when I got sick, Sunday morning at 3 a.m. And I was in hospital. And so all of Sunday I rested, all of Monday. And then on Tuesday was the first day of World Youth Day. Now, I was supposed to meet my group on Sunday already, but I decided to stay with my family to rest. And then on the Tuesday, I decided that I would just go for 2 hours to the Canadian Gathering, which was absolutely amazing. But I still decided to pace myself through all of it. But I realized in the end that it was all a blessing. All of these things were really a blessing, because through the journey of being sick right before World Youth Day, it really allowed me to form a very strong bond with my family. And I really felt that it was God's presence in my life, that my family was there for me in the most vulnerable time. So it was a blessing, you know. If I had gotten sick maybe at a later point, it would have been, much harder. So I had to really learn to live each day, not knowing what was going to happen, not knowing if I was going to be okay to do the whole day of the pilgrimage, or just, pacing myself. So I had a struggle with this. I think this is the most important point to underline, is that it's not something where I was like, okay, it's fine, it's all great.
Yeah.
It was like me being really sad and, crying about it, seeing the people, on TV. I was watching the opening mass on TV because I was too tired to go back on the Tuesday for the whole day. So I stayed with my family. I was watching it on TV. And it was hard to know that I wasn't with my group as well. So I felt kind of sad on that day, but this kind of called me into like a deeper moment with God, and called me to prayer and saying like, you know, I don't know what's going to happen next. Please help me. I feel like sad about this. And so in this kind of honest dialogue with God, and experiencing his mercy also through my family, I was able to like realize that this was a blessing, and that, you know, whatever God's calling me, for in this pilgrimage, I'll learn it day by day what I can do. So I have to just be present in this moment and just like kind of accept what God is, doing in my life in that very moment.
Wow. That definitely sounds like you got a lot from that experience.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, it was, I mean, whenever you do these pilgrimages, it's always about, you know, developing your spirituality and growing closer to God. And you know, we always assume that we know the best way to get closer to God. You know, that it's attending the opening mass and being fully a full participant in every aspect of your World Youth Day is obviously a lot better, we think, than lying in a bed sick and, you know, feeling nauseous.
Yeah.
But I guess you found that, you know, even it's not the situation you would have chosen.
No.
But it's definitely the one that was chosen for you.
Yes. Know?
So, and it's as the whole idea of the pilgrimage is to bring you closer to God, however that happens.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very interesting perspective. You mentioned there was a Canadian gathering, but there were people from almost every country, I guess, over there. So what other groups did you have contact with over there?
Yes, that's a great question. So, you know, all the streets of Panama were filled full of people from everywhere. Now, there were a lot of people from Latin America, so from Honduras or El Salvador or, you know, Costa Rica, which is right a neighbor just north. And then there was a lot of people from everywhere else, even places where, you know, you might have never heard of these countries before. So there were some people from Africa, from Congo, from Togo, from Jamaica. Let's see, what else? From Hong Kong. I could go on forever. There was some from Slovakia.
Mm-hmm.
So even actually on the plane ride to Panama, it was full of people from all over the world. So the experience actually started in the plane. In my plane to Panama, there are people from Slovakia, from South Korea, and from Japan. And then a few from Canada. Most of them were like from Spanish descent. But it was such an interesting mix of people all together on the plane. And they were all going to World Youth Day. And they had so much energy. They were just like already chanting and then singing all this beautiful music, and everybody was kind of joining in, and it was just incredible. And that same energy I felt in Panama when you run into groups, all these different groups, some groups from Brazil, you'd see them walking around with a guitar and singing no matter where they are, just like any street, everywhere. Everybody was dancing, everybody was singing. And then the Panamanians would always honk at all the pilgrims to welcome them. And just the environment
was... Or to get them to move out of the way.
Yeah, well, no. No, they were actually very welcoming. But yeah, no, it was incredible.
It really, I imagine it must have given you a real sense of the universal church.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
Because you're seeing, you know, we're used to our own communities. And, you know... In Catholicism, we're very blessed in that, you know, our faith extends pretty much to every corner of the globe. And, you know, when you have these huge gatherings, you can see how it brings the message of Jesus, you know, can bring so many people of different cultures and backgrounds together. And that's not something that, you know, was the case in the time of Jesus himself, because in his time, you know, the message was really for the Jews. You know, right. It was like they were the chosen people. They were God's chosen people.
Right.
And then Jesus comes and says, now this message is not for just the Jews. It's for the whole world. And so I think sometimes we take it for granted, you know, that great gift that God gave us in Jesus and opening up the gospel and yes. salvation to everybody, not just a chosen few.
Yes,
you know,
and exactly.
You can see that, you know, when you have so many different groups together.
Yeah, I know for sure.
So what was is there one particular experience that kind of stood out in your in World Youth Day for you?
Yes, yes, for sure. So by the end of the week, so I think Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I was doing half of the day of World Youth Day. So I would do like the afternoons. And then I started doing the full day on Friday. But my favorite part, so Friday was the Stations of the Cross, which was absolutely beautiful. However, my favorite part was the vigil, of course. So this is the day where all the pilgrims, you do a lot of walking with all the things that you need to sleep outdoors. So your sleeping bag, food, water, and all the things that you might need. And so you have to pack that all up and then you're going to be walking. We walked about 1.5 hours to 2 hours, not too long. It actually wasn't too bad. And then we were walking all alongside all the pilgrims to our vigil site. Now, our group was pretty awesome in the sense that we split our group into two. Mm-hmm. So one group actually left a bit early so to set up for all of us. So they picked a nice spot and they had tarp and tents and the flag there. So they kind of made a home for us at the vigil site, which was in Metro Park in Panama. And so I was part of the second group. And so then we set out and we went to pick up our food for the 24 hours, which was like a very, very heavy bag that we have to carry with all the rest of our things. Now, one of the people, all of the people in our group were very, kind of thinking of the other people around them. So a lot of people knew that I was sick. So one of my group members, he offered to take or carry my bag for me, which was really amazing because I'm like, I didn't think I could carry all the things that I had, especially in all that heat and all these things. So
how hot was it?
It was about 32. Most days it was 32.
It was like minus 32 here.
Yeah. So, you know, like a 50 to 60 degree difference.
Yeah, gee. That's nice. A little hotter than I like it, but still.
Yeah. So, I mean, it was hot. It's hard to get used to it, right? When you come from like Canada where it's really, really cold. Mm-hmm. So that was actually a shock. But anyway, like carrying all these things, it was good. And everybody was helping each other out. So, you know, if somebody needed a break on the way, then we would take a break. We would make sure to stay hydrated because that was actually a big, you know, problem in a sense. Some people were, you know, if you don't drink enough, you're in big trouble.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we'd walk along all these pilgrims from all over the world. We saw some pilgrims from Mexico, from Argentina, from everywhere. And so we walked all the way there for 1.5 hours. And once we got to the vigil site, it was incredible. So this is where you see all, like the whole world essentially is there, right? Represented. And so we walk and we find our group and they had set up this perfect place for us. It was so beautiful to walk into. Like they had our home there at the vigil. And we were so happy to have a place, you know, once we got into this whole crowd full of people. So it was incredible. So this is kind of the journey to the vigil. And now I'm going to talk a little bit about the vigil itself. Mm-hmm. So what happens after that, once we were all settled in, is that the Pope was coming. Okay. So the Pope was coming for the vigil in his Popemobile. So one of our group members, she actually set up a place for all of us so that we can see the Pope. So it was like right in front of the, a rail. Mm-hmm. And so she saved that spot for us for about like an hour or two just before the Pope was coming. And so we all went there about an hour before the Pope came. We were all ready to see the Pope and and it was incredible. We got to see the Pope so close, right in the first row. So we got to see the Pope pass right by us. And it was like at sunset. So it was absolutely amazing to see. It was...
Did he wave?
No, sadly not. He was kind of looking kind of in the distance, but but it was just amazing to see that. And everybody, all of us were so happy because we had wanted to see him the day before, but there was just so many crowds that we some of us didn't get the chance. So everybody after that, we were just like extremely happy. Our group were, you know, we're all like super excited after that.
We have about 2 minutes left until we have to take a break.
Okay.
But in those 2 minutes, can you basically break it down? What was, you say, Pope Francis's central message for the, for World Youth Day? Just to, we'll get back to it after the break, but.
Okay. Basically, Pope Francis, I think that I really liked his message about, you know, how do young, about young people in general, like, I think he was addressing the idea of how young people often feel invisible in our society, like they feel invisible. And so he was mentioning that, that is kind of the problem as to why a lot of young people don't believe in God, because if a young person doesn't like feels invisible to another human being, how is it possible that they could believe in God, that a God loves them? Okay. And so I think this message was very interesting. So then he went on to talk about the four things that young people need. And he was saying those four things were education, work, family, and community. That these are the roots necessary for young people to dream about a future and also to really learn about God's presence and Jesus's presence in our neighbor, in our community, and to learn about his presence also in the Eucharist, in the church. And so this message was, I think, the most inspiring in a sense of realizing that it starts at us, that we have to kind of provide those roots for young people. I know for myself that that is what I sought after as a young person. And so the fact that he said that, I think that this is kind of something that we have to kind of think about in general as like the Catholic Church, like how can we have this for young people? And I'll just end off with one thing. So he said, only what is loved can be saved and only what is embraced can be transformed. And so I think this kind of summarizes the idea of what young people hope for. They hope to be loved, to be saved, and then to be transformed through that embrace. And the church can then provide this for young people.
Wow. Okay, great message. All right, we want to get back and talk about that more after the break. And I think during the break, we're going to play the theme song from World Youth Day 2019.
Great.
So you guys have a listen to that and then join us back here in just a few minutes and we'll do part two of our interview with Natalie about World Youth Day.
Gathered here today from every continent and city,
longing to be true servants of the Lord, proclaiming your word to every nation.
Teach us to say yes, as Mary did that day, that your will be done here as in heaven.
Speak your word in me and let your
Are listening to Give Me a Voice here on Radio Maria Canada. To contact us and be part of the show, you can tweet us at Radio Maria Can or email voice@radiomaria.ca.
All your sons and your daughters dreaming the dreams of their fathers.